Hello, royalties. I am Grace Cole.
And I am Ana Liana.
And you are tuning into Rules to Them Crowns podcast,
where we touch on combos that wake up the spirit, speak on spiritual alignment, self-awareness, and self-empowerment.
So sit your ass on your throne as we drop Rules to Them Crowns.
Let's get it!
Oh, okay. Make sure you do.
It was absolutely amazing. It was, yeah, the three. It's only three of me. Yeah, they did. Came to celebrate life. Huh? The white was Brianka. The silver was Tender B. And then the red was Grace Cole. And they all came to celebrate their birthday. Really? Like what? Well, it's not really about the color. It's about the look. Oh, Grace in white because she's more of the spiritual. But that's the thing. For the 30th birthday, Grace had to embody a transformative look because I am transforming. I'm in 30s. I don't know.
Yeah,
what is that?
She's trying to dig deep.
Yeah, I don't watch TV.
Yeah, you should actually. It's for the culture.
Yeah. That's what's up. But, you know, during these times, I'm a little bit more careful on what I watch because they are trying to do a lot of conditioning and spell work in television, and it's real.
Yeah, this is for us.
That's why I got the last episode when she made that wish. I would love to watch TV. I really would.
Let's do it.
I get a headache if I do it on my phone. I know. I want a vacation where I could sit and I could just binge watch on stuff and just relax. I don't even got to do nothing. My goal is to go to Mexico in January. No. Not go to Mexico. I don't know.
Mexican man.
I don't know. He's a brown people too, but no.
They're black.
Black man. Not brown man. Black man. I know they black. I understand that. They have.
But yeah, they gotta be.
They have the blood.
Not all of them.
Are, you know, the indigenous people, but.
Not all of them are black either.
They're brown. They're brown people. The brown. They have Afro. No. Afro.
The Haitians that live in the Dominican Republic are Haitians.
No, it's a mixed blood. That's the thing. It's the purity of straight. That is no longer because the colonization of things. Yeah, the colonization of things. So it's like, I understand all of that. But me, you know, the context I'm saying is black. Yeah. Nigga. Negro, you know, that's what I want. I mean, but you never know what the universe may bring. No, I don't see myself messing with a different culture or ethnicity. No, I don't.
Look right past them.
Yeah, I do.
Probably look right past them.
Like, oh, there's a hood nigga. No, I was being funny. I think the breakdown of that is they want a man who is authentic as fuck, like know how to be professional, know how to talk properly when at the right time. Basically, they want a motherfucker that's polar, like you know when to turn shit on and off.
Duality.
And still be you, like not no stuck up ass, corny ass nigga. I it's not for me, and I also had to learn that was a negative trait of mine, because I used to get good guys that came after me, and I'll always go by after the hood niggas, and then I'll be fucked up in the end. So it gotta be a purpose in that hood nigga, not just hood nigga. Yeah, that can absolutely. That's what I'm saying. I had to learn that. That's what I was speaking on just now. Just now in that moment. No, but I had to learn that. And I had to learn that all, like all the types that I was attracting and going after weren't healthy either. But I still don't want no corny ass nigga. And that's just, this is what it is.
Yeah.
I could find, you said what? Someone who does not balance me and on the same frequency mentally and emotionally and spiritually. For me. For me, though.
That's corny.
Because if somebody, so if you're a corny woman, you know, whatever you may look at what that definition is, then that person could be on the same frequency as you and that works for you. But, you know, I can't get, like, loud at times. You know, like, yeah, somebody for me. What's for me is for me. I'm going to get all of what's for me. Everybody. Anybody. I didn't say you was judging. I know you do. I like that, though. Yeah. Help me break it down. Help me break
it's
it down.
It's a problem. You break it down.
Help me break it down. Not the masses, Tone. Not the masses. No, they don't got to be careful because they can do what they want. But oh, yeah, because I don't give permission to certain energies.
Yeah, your intentions lead with you. Mm-hmm. Your intentions lead first.
Uh-huh. But I also, and that's good that we're talking about that because, are we recording? Oh, I thought we were just on there, not like here. This is here and here is there. Oh, okay, okay. Well, I'm glad to be talking about that because I was, you know, I talk to myself a lot and be praying and all of that. So I was thinking about that today and I was like, there's so many people who, when it comes to intentions, even their intentions and mindset about intentions can be ill because some people self-sabotage and they think that people always have ill intentions towards them or they always think that somebody's trying to do something because it don't play out the way that they want it or it doesn't look a certain way. Instead of them just receiving it and letting it flow and then realize like, oh, that wasn't ill intent. So in the end, I just self-sabotage myself for thinking motherfuckers is being ill intended towards me. Yeah. So I'm thinking about that because a lot of people are always speaking on intentions and things like that. And it's like, I get it because if you're trying to have ill intent, that's not good. And it's not okay for you to do that or project that onto people. But not everybody is having an ill intent. It's just, I think your wall of trying to protect yourself becomes self-sabotagement, and then that's you can't receive what you deserve, you know?
That's another situation.
How?
Because it takes time to get over that, you know? It takes time to, because self-sabotage is literally you in your mind
mm-hmm.
going through the same traumas over and over again that you already have that you need to sit and deal with. And if you don't sit and deal with, or if you continue to deal with people and they try to, you know, like they pushing you to try to change that narrative, it's like you got to be able to do that shit on
your own. Your own. Yeah,
but I mean, you still take accountability for the shit too in the meantime. Yeah. Like, and then when you finally get to that point where you realize that it's self-sabotage, like when do you want to stop sabotaging yourself?
Right. Because you can even, and I'm aware of all of that, but that's why I wanted to talk about it because it's like, I'm also aware that people have to have time and that mindfulness and that moment with themselves continuously to work on it and rectify it. It's not going to change overnight. But it's like, if you also have someone or people who is trying to show you, it's like, in the end, it's not their responsibility to, right. But some people care to help you to understand that. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, but when you see it, and even I used to self-sabotage, and I still have moments of self-sabotaging because it's, especially if it's from like a traumatic experience and it brings that up consciously, because the sabotaging part of it is the unconscious behavior that has been embedded, right? And then when you experience it in the physical, it'll like trigger that unconscious feeling.
Yeah,
and so then you like, oh shit, Should I put up a wall? Oh, is this motherfucker playing with me? Or is he trying to be funny? Is he trying to get over? Is she trying to get over? You know, and then you start questioning yourself, and then you go deeper into it, and it's like, yeah, motherfucker, they really love you, or they really trying to show you something different, or they really care about you, or they really were just trying to give you a motherfucking compliment. Like, people go down to even compliments, you know what I'm saying?
Just talking about that.
I do not like that. And it also shows the issues that you are internally battling, you know, like, even with, like, women who, just my new shit, like, women who be like, he thirsty, or he's just giving you a compliment that you should embrace and know that you're worthy of, if he's telling you you're beautiful, or if he's, you know, telling you, oh, let me hold this door for you, Miss Lady. But it don't mean he thirsty. Yeah. He's just trying to hold the fucking door for you, bitch.
It's your decision to take shit to the next
And
level.
It's funny because I've transformed in that area, because when I was younger, I was worse than myself, sabotaging. And I'm gonna tell y'all a funny ass experience. And you know, I'm really confident in myself. And so I was at the gas station. I was like 20. I was at the gas station. And this dude was trying to talk to me. And then I got my little stank face on and shit like that. And then he was still being nice or whatever. And then when we got, so I went in, paid for my gas, got back out, was paying for my gas. I mean, pumped my gas. And then when I'm leaving, he beeping at me. And I'm like, what the fuck do he want? Like, ugh. He like, damn, bitch, I was just trying to tell you your lights wasn't on. I was so salty. I was so salty. And I think that was one of my first experiences to make me be conscious of my behavior when it comes to dude. Like, I wasn't mean like that, but I'd be like just ignoring them and shit. You know, and I still ignore to a certain extent, but I'm very pleasant to anybody. Like, if I get compliments, if somebody held the door, somebody tell me I look beautiful, I turn them away in a pleasant and respectful way, because you don't have to be rude, you know. And I personally know people that I am cool with and friends with that have been shot by men because they being rude and turn them down in a rude ass way. And now this nigga, you don't know what he dealing with. So now he mentally fucked up and emotional and get mad at you and feel like, bitch, you trying to do him, and now he's shooting your ass. I ain't trying to be nobody victim, and I ain't gonna be nobody victim.
And that's another thing too, like the too friendly shit. Like, I'm a nice person. Like,
boundaries. Kind. You're a kind person.
I'm a kind person.
Nice is making other people comfortable.
Yeah. I'm a kind person, and I mean, I feel like maybe people are attracted to a light that I have, or maybe they just want to see what the fuck it is type shit. I think that it'd be like that, something like that. So sometimes, I was just talking to my best friend about this, and she was like, people just talk to you and you don't even care. Like, you talk to crazy motherfucker. You talk to people who just like, and that's always been who I was. Like, the people at the table, like the people in school that nobody would talk to, or like the people that people call weird or something. I would talk to them.
That was me. And it's
like
them.
And it's like you entertaining them. You entertaining them. You giving people opportunity to think that they have a chance with you, but it's like, no, it don't get past that. It just be like, I'm not entertaining shit. Like, it just be.
Isn't that just can't that be considered just a humane gesture of,
yeah, that's what I'm
embracing
saying.
Embracing, like, people and who either, they are, and acknowledging them?
It's either you too nice, or you get the too nice, you too friendly, or it get, damn, I just wanted to give you a compliment. But then when I take the comment, I'm like, oh, thank you. It's like, damn, bitch, you look too nice. But it's like, damn, you motherfuckers can't win for losing. Like, it's a gray area.
Yeah. That's why you can't take shit personal when people react or respond the way that they want to respond.
Exactly. Because it's like, that's how you want it, right?
Yeah.
That shit don't affect me.
People do be weird, yo.
Definitely. And I be knowing sometimes too, and then be like, you weird, but it's cool. Me too.
Yeah, because I was just going to say that. I was like, I'm weird as fuck too. Yeah. Motherfuckers be like, I'm be like, yeah, bitch, you weird, but that's cool because you know, you don't got to answer to nobody.
Right.
If you wanted to not have anybody in your life or talk to anybody, you don't have to. That's a choice. That's a decision to engage and experience other people, because you really don't have to. Yeah. So once you do, should you really be upset at their behaviors or who they're being? Because just like, you don't have to answer to no one or embrace anyone. They don't have to answer to you or be a certain way. But the ego part of self and the physical self, when you experience it, you be like, this motherfucker. Yeah. But like, I embrace that. That's me.
Like,
yeah.
Do I do that too? I probably do that to a motherfucker who I don't like. Mm-hmm. And it's like, damn. Or I probably do that to a motherfucker who I just do it off the strength of that's just probably what I do at the moment, not knowing how it comes off. Because it's just something you doing because you're you and not knowing how it come off sometimes.
Because you used to being you.
Right. And so it's like, damn, do I move off the ego? Damn, do I, you know, like it just be certain shit that you be having to take accountability of. Mm-hmm. Like a motherfucker keep telling you the same shit. It's kind of like, maybe you don't have to listen. Or maybe this might help you in your mm-hmm. life further down the line. Like you mm-hmm. don't have to listen to everything somebody say. But if it really sit with you and you be like, damn, okay, I've been hearing this for a mm-hmm. long time now. Mm-hmm. Maybe I do this. Or maybe this is a problem. Or maybe, no, but it's also like...
Or maybe I could just be a little bit more mindful of it. It don't mean that,
right?
You know...
Changing your whole self to benefit. Yeah. I mean, to make somebody else happy.
Exactly. Yeah. It's more of just like, okay. Well, yeah, that situation.
Yeah.
Let me not, in the future, if that situation happens again, or if I come across... or experience something similar, let me make sure I don't do that again. Because now I at least I acknowledge this specific situation. Or you could just move forward and be like, you know what? I'm going to move differently in my ego, you know, because it could be unhealthy for you as well. Because, you know, what you project out can affect other people. Yeah. But at the end of the day, you still don't have to answer to them either. So it's really solely up to you.
Yeah.
And a lot of people don't understand that. That's even like... with like how your lifestyle is or who you choose to be.
Yeah, you got more control than you think.
Yeah, than you think. But it's important that you acknowledge if someone is speaking on something that could be considered unhealthy or not fair or something like that. So I try to do that. Not try, I don't like to say try. I work on doing that because I know I'm not perfect. We are imperfect, perfect beings, you know, that the Most High created. So the biggest thing, which is a form of repentance, is just going over and looking at your behaviors and even what people have said about you and rectifying it if it is considered unhealthy. Because we're intelligent beings. Yeah. We know. At the end of the day, we feel it in our intuitive self what's wrong and what's right.
Yeah.
Some people really don't, though. And, I can't explain those type of motherfuckers. But, you know, it is what it is. But I know what I feel. And I know when I feel something is not right, especially if somebody let me know. Yeah. And then I analyze it. So then at that point, I'm like, okay, let me rectify it. So I feel like other individuals should work on that as well.
Yeah. I mean, once you take things from the Most High, you vibrate in your Most High. Like, once you start to really, like, it feel good when you really know that you're doing what is right or not even
you
what's
feel
right.
It.
Yeah, you feel that shit. You know when you're working, when you're really putting in work, you know, because you receive that gratification. Mm-hmm. Regardless how you receive it, regardless if you've been working your ass off at work, and your paycheck is, you get a nice ass paycheck.
Mm-hmm.
You are granted that abundance after you put that work in.
Mm-hmm.
That's literally everything in life. Mm-hmm. Once you start to put in those steps and take those risks and actually put your best
foot forward. It's the karmic energy that comes back to you.
Yeah, once you start vibrating on those Most High frequencies, then you get everything from the Most High. Mm-hmm. Everything around you start to just gravitate.
And you're just taken care of. Yeah. And you really don't have to worry about much. And then that should also boost you to start expecting your abundance and appreciating it too.
Yeah.
And then, like you said, once you vibrate in that, you receive the energies, which energy is vibration.
Yeah.
And so if you're vibrating low or unhealthy or low moving with the devil, as they say, you're going to attract of those low vibrating energies in your life, not just with people, but your experiences.
Everything. Worry.
Your money don't be right. Yeah. You start to worry. Worry is a low vibrational thought and energy.
It's minimal. You worrying about things is minimal. Shit that you, if you can't control it and you worrying about it, you self-sabotaging yourself.
Exactly.
Because if it's something that you can think yourself out, if it's something that you can place yourself in a different mindset and you can place yourself in that, you can place yourself in that state. If you can change your mindset, you can place yourself exactly where you want to be. If you just take like certain steps, like with my anxiety, like it's like, okay, I don't want to take certain steps. Why? Like now, like I recently just got like anxiety just don't fucking exist to me. Like it just, I really, cause it's like, it's not for me. It's not something mm-hmm. that actually is something that is.
You don't have to claim it.
No, because mm-hmm. it's not like, what the fuck? Mm-hmm. Like I took one step in the beginning of the month, and I'm like, okay, I really shouldn't be taking this step. Me thinking, my logical mind thinking, like, I shouldn't be taking this step. Like, not even shouldn't be taking it. But it's like, if I do this, then what the fuck? Like, what am I going to do for the rest of the month? Or what am I going to do for? Mm-hmm. And it's just like, fuck it. Why are you thinking about that?
Mm-hmm.
Why are you thinking about the rest of the month? Why not think about today? Why not think about what you could benefit from this, and then take your mind to a state where it's like, if you know that you got this, you got to have faith in yourself. If you don't believe that shit, then that shit ain't going to come to you. Mm-hmm. If you really don't believe something, how could you really think that it's going to come true?
Mm-hmm.
You don't even believe in yourself mm-hmm. at this point. You mm-hmm. know, you got all the tools that you need, and you denying those tools, mm-hmm. you have them.
But that's why it's important that people really work on their mental and their spiritual mm-hmm. alignment, because then you can it'll be easier for you to get out of it. You know, mental discomfort is very common and can always be experienced.
Yeah.
But then it's when the mental illness part of it, or the severe mental discomfort yeah. sets in because of where your mental is right. and your spirit is, and then people start to claim it at that point.
Mm-hmm.
But when you are working on yourself, or you spirit more spiritually aligned and mentally transformed, mm-hmm. you know that it's just an experience
yeah.
and you don't have to claim it. And that's where I had to come with my anxiety that I experience from time to time. And I ain't finna sit here and act like when I'm experiencing it, I'll be all over the motherfucking place. I'll be all over the motherfucking place. And I hate that I have to be all over the motherfucking place with it. Yeah. I don't like how it feels.
Yeah.
But when I acknowledge it, I'm like, shit. And then I have my moments because, you know, we're human.
Right.
You know, that part of us can take over. But the important part is, because I'm more transformed in my mind and more spiritually vibrating at a different level, I'm able to get out of it. Yeah. I know what I have to do. I just have exactly. to get to the place of saying, okay, let me get this shit in check now.
Yeah, that's
and that's the difference. If somebody isn't mentally transformed or healthier, let's say healthier, they gonna just sit in that shit.
Yeah,
and then they claim it.
Yeah, it's like training. It's like you literally training. You training. All of the spirals that you go through while you are experiencing anxiety, or you are experiencing those ailments, that's just training. Like, if you don't really, if you know, if you talk to yourself while you going through that shit, and you like, you get irritated with yourself, you start self-sabotaging yourself, then the real you starts to come out, and you start to think logical.
Mm.
And you're emotional. You're irrational.
Yeah.
You can't fully think of how you would actually think. It's a chemical reaction in your brain, mm-hmm. and it's not frequency and the same as how your body thinking, your body feeling a certain type of way, but your brain is mm-hmm. on a completely different level from mm-hmm. your. It's an imbalance. So
and that's why you got to align the two.
Yeah. So you going through that training. That training is you know that drill sergeant that's telling you in your own head, like, why am I doing this? What are you doing? You could just relax. Just fucking relax. Like, just chill. If you just chill, then you'll be good. Mm-hmm. That's you training yourself. If mm-hmm. you actually start to listen to that drill sergeant, and you be like,
you start conditioning yourself.
Exactly. You like, you're right. All I got to do is do this mm-hmm. to become a better. All I got to do is do this to get my medal.
Mm-hmm.
That's it. I know that I got to do that anyway. I'm telling myself that I got to do that anyway. Why the fuck is my body telling me that's not what mm-hmm. I need to be doing? What is the problem? Like, yeah. what is causing this?
Or being in the moment of saying, okay, let me be real with myself.
Yeah.
How did I get to this place?
Right.
Oh, because my motherfucking ass
yeah.
sat on my phone for
yeah.
30 minutes.
Yeah.
And now I'm rushing
yeah.
to get where the fuck I need to go. And now my anxiety done kicked yeah. in. But my ass is the reason
yeah.
that this shit is kicking in yeah. now. That's me.
Yeah, that's your drill sergeant.
That's me.
That's you telling, like,
but that accountability is so imperative
yeah.
to being better with how yeah. you move through your experiences.
Yeah.
And I learned that. So when I'm acting a fool or all overwhelmed and shit, I'll be like, bitch, you know that you just mm-hmm. did this, that, and the other. Or, bitch, calm down, go meditate, go relax, breathe. Or sit and breathe. If I'm somewhere where I can't really get in my comfortable place and meditate and, you know, say my prayers or anything to calm me down, I do breathing technique. The breath is very, very powerful when it comes to you relaxing, with you calming yourself down and helping with circulation in your
right.
brain, all of that. So it's important. You can just do breathing techniques
exactly.
and that can get you there. I had a moment 2 days ago and I was like losing my shit. And I was like, okay, I just took my ass outside and I just sat on, I got these little stumps out there and I sat and I just sat in the sun and I was breathing. I had to breathe because I was truly overwhelmed the other day. And then, you know, my kids got to feel that and they see that. Mm-hmm. And then I'm getting, you know, the irritability comes in and the sporadic spaz outs and snapping. And I noticed myself doing that to them. And I'm like, ooh, okay. It you know, they're doing shit, but it's really me and what I'm feeling. So let me take my ass outside and take a breather.
Exactly. And then when you come back from that, then what you're doing, you the one, you telling the somebody else that had to witness your anxiety, what you would be telling yourself. Like, I apologize. You apologizing to yourself. You ain't even apologize. You apologizing to your kids because they a physical form, or you apologizing to the person who you had to lash out at, but you really apologizing to yourself because you like, I didn't need to let myself get to that point because you really didn't do nothing. You just an outside source from what's going on in my fucking brain. Mm-hmm. And that be really what it is. It's like, once you start to really realize that shit, and once you start to like breathing, I forget to breathe when I'm having anxiety attack. Mm-hmm. That shit literally feel
me
like a
too. I stop and I feel it. And that's why, and I'll have to remind myself to breathe, which is why when I was spazzing out too, I'm like, let me go outside, fresh air, which is healing, breathing the fresh air, which is healing, sitting in the sun and just relaxing and even taking my energy away from my children because that's not fair to them either. Right. And that's accountability as well. And so I'm like, let me just do that. And then when I came back, I was so much better, you know? And it's like, I know people experience those type of emotions, you know, depression as well. And it's like, I don't put people down for it, but when you start to live in it and make an excuse, I'm going to say something about that. Because now you're just being an excuse.
Yeah, but at that point, it's like, I try not to do that for the simple fact that I know how I feel. Because, shit, I'm still training. Sometimes, like, shit, I'm still in training. I ain't really earned my medal yet, for real. I got to a point where I got a badge, but I ain't make it to general status.
But that's the imperfection, though. You don't have to get to a place where it's that's perfect. True. That's not what I'm saying.
And no, but I'm saying, like, as far as, like, if y'all soldiers, I've been a soldier before. I've been in that training. I've been in that before. So it's like, I see you trying. Like, if I don't see you trying, then it's like, I can't say shit because it was a point where when I was in training, I wasn't trying. Mm-hmm. Like, I wasn't. But if I had, even if I had somebody to be like, come on, you need to try, that shit ain't gonna matter to me.
Yeah.
Because what matters to me is what I need to tell myself. Exactly. Like, a person telling you that you not doing good enough, or a person telling you that you are doing good, that shit ain't gonna matter because it's not coming from the source. Because you can't believe it. If you tell me something, I probably ain't gonna believe it.
But some people do work off of that validation as well. So that's why, you know, that's why I'm the type that be like, listen, I understand, but this, I'm gonna fucking tell you what the fuck you looking like. Yeah. I'm not gonna put you down. I'm not gonna say you ain't good enough. I'm gonna be like, I'm gonna speak on the fact, the objective fact of what you're doing.
And the point that you at. It's like, I've been there.
So
I know,
it's not like,
I know where you at right now. Don't even.
Or even if I never experienced, I understand that you are going through this right now, but this is what you shouldn't do to yourself. Or this is a suggestion or advice of what you could work on or could do. But what you're doing right now ain't it. It ain't going to do nothing for you. Yeah. And some people need to really hear that sometimes. Yeah. Does that mean that it's going to resonate or that they're going to listen? No. But I try to work as a vessel and do what I can and relay it. And then once I take the horse to the water, I can't make you drink it, but I can at least make sure I did my part, you know, as a vessel, because that's all we are as well, to make sure I, you know, relay that to you. So it's important that we all do that to each other and for each other.
Utilize each other.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Those placements, like, people are being placed everywhere for you to have to experience. Like, if it's a lesson that you need to, that becomes negative, but you have to turn it into a positive lesson, or if it's a lesson that is, you see what they doing and you don't want that for yourself, you know what I'm saying? Like, people are being placed in your life for a reason. Like, certain situations that I see other people going through, I can be like, damn, that's fucked up. And you place yourself in, like, damn, if I was in that situation, I don't know how I could do it. Mm-hmm. Or, like, I don't know how you handling that, but you handling it how you handle it. So I can't really speak on how you handling it. You know what I'm saying?
Because it's not you.
Right. And I don't know if that's speaking off of, like, a mind your situation. Because I feel like if I'm placed in a certain space, it's for me to, I just don't be feeling like it'd be for me to speak on certain shit at a certain time. Like I, but I don't care enough either. That's another thing. Like, I mean, I don't even be caring enough. Like even if I am like, I only, when I feel used, like I feel utilized, that's when it'd be like, damn, I just told this motherfucker some information that I needed to hear myself. That's the only time I'm talking to people about something that they're going through. You know what I'm saying? Because it's like, I'm talking to you, but I'm talking to me. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can only talk on your situation because I am talking to, this is something that I need to hear. This is not something that I need you to hear from me. This is something that I need to hear for me to send it to you. Because mm-hmm. I'm taking this shit and I'm taking this shit back home and I'm hearing this from, mm-hmm. I'm listening to how you respond back to me, because it's like, you understand what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like, you understand.
Reflection.
Yeah, that's literally when I feel like I be utilized. That's when I am able to, you know, put myself in and be utilized or be used as my vessel is being used in those instances. Mm-hmm. So it's just like, I don't know.
But everybody's different. So and that's, you don't true. Have to say, I don't know. That's
but,
just.
But, and that's really what are, it is. Like, yeah. Everybody different.
Some people are individuals that have a conversation, almost be a life coach to people, you know, mm-hmm. when they're experiencing things. Then you got motherfuckers that be like, they're there.
Yeah.
Or you got people that be like, oh, yeah. You know, like, what do you expect me to say? And yeah. It's like, that's when it
that be me.
Is the other person's responsibility to know, like, they don't owe you shit
that
because
be
you truly.
That be me.
Yeah, but, you know, but I get it. The emotional part of it be like, damn, do you care?
No, it'd be like that.
No, I'm saying, like, speaking from a person who is the person who's not getting.
I know, and that'd be the thing. Like, when I used to be working and shit, I used to work around all women. So they come to me because they know that I give advice, or I be giving advice sometimes, or they just like to talk to me. So, like, they used to do shit like show me signs that they not feeling good. Because when you ain't feeling good around me, I kind of be like, you good? You all right? And they're like, how did you know? And it'd be like, all right, I'm just want to know if you good. I don't kind of want to know everything behind it. But it'd be like, they be kind of wanting me to ask because they want to talk. Mm-hmm. And I'd be getting that too. And it'd be like.
But then they have to understand you're not.
Yeah, or a motherfucker just be crying behind me or some shit. It'd be like, what? Do you hear me crying, bitch? Ask me what's wrong with me. It's like, I don't think it's my time. I don't think me being you, I don't think, if I didn't say shit, I feel like that it wasn't meant for me to say shit. I feel like I wasn't used in that moment. I don't feel like it was, I don't need to be utilized in your life.
They'd be
right
like,
now.
You're so heartless.
No, that's probably what it'd be too. But it'd be like, I'm not though. I just really don't be wanting. I don't be wanting. When I feel, when my intuition speak, my intuition will tell me if I need to speak on some shit, if I don't. Like, if my intuition say, like, maybe even you just being around this person, or maybe you even just asking, like, are you okay? And that's it. That's maybe that's sometimes that's all a person need. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, if my spirit don't say, go for the long haul, I ain't going for the long haul. My spirit chill as fuck. So it'd be like, and especially with other people. So it'd be like, I don't, because I'd be so in my mind that I can't even, sometimes I can't even give you no advice. I can't give you no advice unless I'm giving it to myself. If I tell you something, it's because I need to hear that shit myself. I can't give you no advice on no shit that I don't need to hear myself.
You trying to work on what you got.
Yeah, that's exactly. So like, that's my whole thing. Like if I'm not being, I don't know, like, I mean, not I don't know in a sense, like, but it's like, I'm just one of those other people that are being played. I just feel like I be on a chessboard and I just be getting moved around sometimes I'm like, damn, did I need to be here right now? Yeah, maybe I did. Like, maybe I do need to learn this lesson right now. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Well, cool. If it happens, then it's divine order.
Yeah, that's exactly all it is. So that's what it'd be like. That's why I'm saying, like, if my intuition and my spirit doesn't say, then I'm not. And
do you feel like there's ever moments where you feel like
I should have said something?
You should have said something?
No. Oh, no. Nah. I don't be feeling like that because I feel like once I do say, because I'm a talkative person, it's not like I don't be talking. It's not like I just be like, I'm not a quiet person. I speak when certain shit matters to me. And I speak with passion most of the time. I do be talking. So it's like, I can tell you some shit about some shit, but if I can't tell you shit about shit, I really don't want to speak on it. Especially if not even to please you, because it's like, I don't have a fear of saying the wrong things. I'm just not talking for the simple fact that I don't have a fear of saying the wrong things. I just, that's not the right thing for me to say at the moment. My spirit don't say it. Like it's something that I just won't speak. Mm-hmm. Like I just won't say anything. If I don't have the words for it, that means it's not time for me to speak on it. Like if you asking me something and it's like,
that makes sense.
Yeah, like if you asking me something and just like, damn, where to answer at? And it's like, I can't speak on that right now. I don't have the answer for you.
So right? Have you ever had experiences with individuals that made someone feel some type of way?
Like what?
Like if you don't speak on something.
I'm sure we all have. But it's also like those answers sometimes come out without you even having to ask those questions. Yeah. You already find out what you really want to find out from a person by talking to them, you know, like by actually listening to them without even having to talk to them like that. If you listen to a person, you can find out everything that you really need to know. Yeah. You ain't gonna ask them too many questions. Mm-hmm. Your answer is gonna come out, especially if they're talking, because most of the time when somebody talking, they talking about themselves. Most of the time somebody talking to somebody else, they talking about themselves. Like you talking about a situation, but most of the time you taking it personal because you speaking on your experience.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
So it's like everything that I really need to know about you, I can figure out by not even, so you get all the answers. You know, that's how you say corny niggas. You know about how a nigga talking, about how he put themselves in a certain situation and know, like, I don't want to fuck with nobody like that. I don't even, like, why would I want, I don't even know how you operate, but I see something in you that makes me not want to, you know what I'm saying?
The behavior, the actions.
Right. So it's like.
The language.
Yeah. So it's like certain situations, like I not even to, like, I know I'm pretty sure that I do a lot of shit that be like, well, what the fuck? Why the fuck do you do that? Or what the fuck? Why was that? What was that for? Like, certain shit like that. But it's like, sometimes I don't even be like, it don't be intentional. Like, it don't be intentional that I'm making somebody feel a certain type of way. I just, if I did, my fault. I don't know how I was moving in that situation. Like, I don't know if I was moving in a certain situation. I don't know if it was to,
you move for you.
Do I?
Huh? You said it multiple times. You speak on shit when it,
yeah,
for you.
Yeah, that's true.
So that's the movement. That's how, but that's, who says that that's wrong,
right,
though?
Right.
But at the same time, that's how you move. But when it's not understood at times to certain people.
Yeah.
Or if you're dealing with an individual,
yeah,
that doesn't move like that, then that language isn't understood.
Yeah, you know? I get that.
Actions is the language as well.
Yeah, that's true.
And if your language is at a place where people are not comprehending or understanding it, then it could be looked at as a negative thing.
Sometimes my language would be shit that I don't even comprehend. If I listen back to certain shit that I say sometimes, I'd be like, what was I talking about? Because you don't really think when you be talking all this, like, all the time. Like, you sometimes you really just being utilized. Like, you really just be talking from a certain state. You either be talking from a low, you be talking from a high.
Mm-hmm. The high is being the vessel.
Yeah.
The low is the ego.
Yeah, but not, I don't think that, I don't, not technically.
For me. I guess I'll say for me.
Yeah, like, ego is not a bad thing, because everybody has it. Everybody speaks from ego. Everybody, because when you speaking from ego, you're speaking to another person, and ego is just how another person views you. So it's just how another person views you. So it's like, however you see my ego, do you see my ego as how is it vibrating to you? You know, like it's perception, I guess. That's really all that
is. I just said that though.
Yeah.
It's your language. The language is the perception that people are going off of.
Yeah. Yeah. That's true.
So that's, again, it's a internal and personal.
Everything is.
Everything. And it's a lot of, I don't think no one will ever perfect every area of understanding and fully if we still are in this physical state and experience things.
Yeah.
That also, no matter what, you can still be affected emotionally.
Yeah.
So it's like, if you're going to be affected emotionally with experiences, you still going to embrace the emotion that comes with it.
Yeah, because you have to, the lessons that comes with it is what you have to learn. You have to learn, could this be something that elevates me? Most of the time, when somebody do some shit to you and you have to learn, most of the time, it's a positive. You turn that shit into a positive. Mm-hmm. All the time. Like, if you could turn it into a negative, but that's you vibrating low and you letting the lows turn into a negative. You know what I'm saying? Like,
or you could be absorbing the projection that's being given to you.
Yeah.
And cause you to be at a low.
Yeah.
And then at that point, it's not even your emotion.
No, it's somebody else's.
And people get that often. Yeah. You know, the transference of energy. The transference of all of that is that shit real. Yeah. So it's like, that's why you gotta make sure you're protecting yourself, or, you know, if you're going through a emotional experience or an unhealthy experience, it's important that you always get to a place of mindfulness to remind yourself, like, hold the fuck up.
Yeah.
Let me shake this shit. Yeah. Let me release this, because it's not even my emotion.
Yeah.
It's this motherfucker's.
Yeah, or how a motherfucker would be like, you this. Are you, am I really that? Or are you just saying some shit to me to make it seem
because
like I'm that?
So because you're projecting how you feel about me.
Right.
Not how I know that I am.
Yeah.
And that's why it's important people protect themselves and be confident and know what the fuck they are.
Yeah.
But it also can be eventually conditioned onto you. Like, if somebody's always projecting how they feel about you in a negative light, you can start to be conditioned to that and absorb it, and then start thinking it and start feeling bad. It's like abuse.
Yeah.
You know, like with abuse, you know, emotional abuse, it could then become the spiritual effects of it. And then the physical comes with it, because now they have reached the heights of the emotional abuse, the breakdown. Yeah. Boom. I did that. The mental. And then now, now I could start being on the physical level of the abuse.
Or just keep it on the emotional and mental, because that's all that's really the real control. If you keep it on the mental and you keep it on the emotional, then you don't even have to get to the physical, because you done lock everything that you need to unlock off those two things.
Exactly.
So, like, I ain't got to physically, because those last longer. Mental abuse and emotional abuse, those last longer.
Absolutely.
And it causes the physical abuse. It's like, I don't even want to put my hands on you, for the simple fact that I ain't that type of person. You know what I'm saying? But it's like, just because a motherfucker don't put their hands on you,
doesn't mean you're not going through an abuse.
Yeah, that doesn't mean that you... Especially if you're not feeling good about the situation. If there's something telling you there's something going on, if you completely changing everything that you were thinking about yourself, and then now it's completely different because now that you start talking to this person, or now that this person around you, they start to fuck with your thoughts a little bit. They kind of altering your reality a little bit, and you kind of questioning that now.
Yeah.
It's you being abused, and you might...
And you start being conditioned to what they've been projecting out onto you.
Yeah.
And so now you start moving differently. Yeah. You start moving how they want you to move, or you start moving in an unhealthy way, or just even depression.
Yeah.
And then...
Now you're stuck, or you don't even...
I've been in a place where I didn't realize it, you know, being emotionally and mentally abused. And then I think I'm fine, as long as I'm not physically getting abused. Yeah. But then, you know, you got loved ones and other people seeing it.
Yeah.
And then they're like, dude. And you're like, no, I'm good.
Yeah.
ain't nothing going on.
Yeah, that's the thing.
But also your pride, you know, don't want to admit to it.
You don't want to admit that.
You don't want to admit to that.
Your ego don't want to admit to it.
Your ego do not want to admit.
You like, fuck that. I can never happen to me.
Yeah. And you know, like, even with that statement saying that can never happen to me, I had to be humble in so many areas. And I also, you know, looking back at it, I that was a confirmation that my tongue is powerful. I'm a manifester and a creator, which we all are. But I remember it was times where I'd be like, I'll never go through this. I'll never go through that. Mm-hmm. I'll never go. Bitch, God was like, boom, here you go, bitch. Exactly. Here you go. Yeah. Here you go in that area. Yeah. Oh, here you go in this other area, too. It made me experience all that shit.
Yeah, but then you get back like, up off that shit.
Yeah, but it's like the hump. I had to stop the judgment and, you know, making others feel bad for what they're going through.
Exactly.
And God said, let me show you how that is, you
that's
know.
How that shit, that's how it be, too. And that's really the whole, like, especially when it comes to abuse, like, women, like, talk about, like, I never let a nigga put his hands on me, or I never. That could possibly be so. But a motherfucker don't have to put their hands on you physically for them to fuck you over in the end. Like, a person, most of the times it comes through as a good guy, you know? Because it comes through as a good guy. It comes through in the form of sheep. You know, like
sheep and wolves.
Yeah,
wolves and sheep's clothing.
Yeah, so it's like if it looked like a sheep, you can't be a wolf. I don't see it. I don't. You're not finna. A wolf will literally hunt your ass down and do what it needs to do on the hunt. You know, it's gonna bring you down. You know how gate that you're running from a wolf.
Well, the logic of it is, why would I show you that I'm a wolf right away?
Exactly.
Like, that'll just be stupid because I know then you're not going to even experience me.
Right.
So let me swindle myself in and be this great guy.
Charm
or women too. Women can be, women definitely can be abusers. I've had my abusive moments where it wasn't healthy. Yeah. Not trying to be funny, but I mean, you know, I was acting off of my emotions.
Yeah.
You know, and then I became abusive mentally.
But that's another thing too, because of if I was abused, and if I know what mental abuse feel like, and I don't do it knowingly, I'm just as bad as the person who did the shit to me. Just for even letting that projection fall onto me and then projecting it out unknowingly, because it's something in my mental, it's something that I'm doing unconsciously at this point. It's like, damn, am I mentally abusive as a motherfucker? Like,
or your emotions is just reacting.
Right.
Your emotions is just reacting.
Yeah.
And then it's like, so then you can embrace it and be like, damn, okay, this hurts, or I'm upset.
Yeah.
And, you know, you're going to act off of them, or you can be logical within the moment and be like, okay, this shit hurt. This made me upset. But I'm going to be conscious enough to know that two wrongs don't make a right. And that isn't the best decision. And I've been in situations where I didn't realize that until later, you know, because I'm just acting off my emotion. And then later on, I'm like, well, damn, shouldn't have done that.
And now you know what it is now.
Yeah.
And it'd be like that too. But it also be like, you don't even feel the intentions when it comes to abuse. And that's the crazy thing.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the intentions don't be there until afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and that's the crazy thing, how everybody say lead off and lead off of intention. Most of the time, the intentions be to get you in a state where you free. You feel good. You feel good.
The topic is abuse. Somebody asked what was the topic. It's abuse.
But when it comes to abuse, though, you know, like, if let's just speak on not being biased, not being one-sided, because I'm not that type of individual. Mm-hmm. But, you know, since we're ladies, let's speak on the abusive, like, men.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a lot of times they are unconsciously being this way because of how, you know, their childhood traumas and what they've experienced. Is that an excuse? Absolutely not.
Right.
But moving forward in their head, what they're doing is, I'm going off of how I feel and what I feel like should be the best, or what you should do for me, or what I think it should go, how it should go.
Yeah.
And then when you're doing the opposite of what my expectation is, what I know is to beat your ass, or what I know is to be emotional and cuss you the fuck out and put you down so that you can get back, so you can know how I feel and get back to a place to do how I want you to do.
Yeah.
And it's like, that's not fair. And women have to understand that, you know, when they're experiencing that type of behavior, at the end of the day, that ain't love.
No, not at all.
It's not love at all. And even though we may love a motherfucker, because I'm a lover. I know how, you know, when I was going through my situation, I was in love, but you couldn't tell me shit. You couldn't tell me shit. Oh, well, he just, you know, he said he was sorry, you know? And yeah. It's like, we think that that's good enough. And then every time we make that decision to forgive, but forgive in an unhealthy way, mm-hmm. we're belittling our worth.
Yeah, just
and then your worth just get
you comfortable with
more and more minute.
Yeah, you comfortable with the abuse because you don't know the long lasting effects of it if it's not physical abuse. Mm-hmm. You don't know how long that you
but
know
even
how long
the physical like there's women saying. Who have get their ass beat. Yeah, all
but
the
I'm
time.
Saying it's but I'm saying and most of those women are being abused in. All forms.
All areas. And that's what's
keeping them.
Yeah, that's what's keeping them. Yeah. Because all of these areas are being bonded. You know what I mean? Yeah. So
it's like, why can't you leave? Why don't you leave? It's the physical abuse is not going to run me away if I'm being mentally and emotionally abused if I don't know why the fuck, what the fuck I need to do. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? If you don't have answers because your answers have been taken away from you, really, because you don't even know how to think for yourself. You thinking off somebody else's mind. Mm-hmm. You thinking off the mind that somebody is like they gave you at this point.
You're no longer empowered within yourself because you have now been conditioned with
brainwashed
with the projections of his emotions,
of her emotions, or her
his thoughts, or her. If you're in, you know, if the LGBT community.
Or if you're a man who just be getting mentally abused by women too. So
yeah, but like, I'm with in this conversation, we're talking about a male and a woman. Yeah, you irritate. Yeah. But anyways, whoever you're with, you will become lost within yourself because you have all these avenues and projection that has been brainwashed and conditioned onto you. And so now yourself is hidden somewhere or covered somewhere. Yeah. And so you're not connecting with it. To be like, this really ain't okay. Yeah, you know, you start thinking how they're thinking. Yeah. Oh, he loved me,
that's
though. He said he loved me.
That's a fact.
He said he loved me. He paid these bills.
Yeah.
So that's all I'm thinking about. He's good to the kids.
Right.
That's all I'm thinking about. That's what he tell me all the time, too. So then at that point, that's all you thinking about. Yeah. You're not thinking about you being abused. You're not thinking about your worth being
right. You're not thinking about
away.
How you would feel if you were actually able to think for yourself. If you had a free mind, you don't think about that no more because you're comfortable in having a mind that is in conjoined with another's mind. You know what I'm saying? Like our minds are conjoined. We're comfortable here. Why do we need to have our own separate minds at this point? And that's weird as hell to say out loud. You know what I'm saying? But that's how shit be. Really, like when you being abused, like you attached, somebody else is abusing you.
Mm-hmm.
And if nobody else, somebody has already abused you, so now you're abusing yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so you
their
stuck
abuse
with
becomes
that.
Your abuse.
Yeah, you stuck with that. So for you, that you're conjoined by this, you're conjoined with this person. Mm-hmm. You let this person have an impact on your life where they change your completely, your whole thought process. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So
not to mention the soul tie, too, of being, you know.
Facts.
The sexual transferring of energy, that's real too. So now you got all these different avenues of abuse, you know? And it's heavy. It can be really heavy. It can be difficult. It can be very emotional and hard. And, you know, sometimes people may feel like if they leave, they wouldn't have nothing. If they leave, nobody wouldn't love them, you know? Because also you've been conditioned to think that too.
And you're comfortable. So you're not thinking about what could happen next. You're not willing to take that step because you're stuck in comfortability because this is what you know now. Mm-hmm. This is who you are now. This is what you know now. You don't know what's going to come next after you completely change your life. Your life is going to be completely changed if you
just make this one step.
You're not.
But that's the trust. That's a part of the trust within yourself. Exactly. But you know, if your trust isn't built, or if your trust was broken down, your self-trust and self-worth was broken down, it's not going to be easy to just connect with that.
Not at all.
So you...
Especially if you don't break free from that person who abused you. You can break free from, they ain't going to hit you no more. All right. Motherfucker tell you they ain't going to hit you no more. You think that you scot-free. Everything is just so much better.
Mm-hmm.
that shit don't stop. That shit don't stop because they still there.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine a motherfucker whooping your ass and you just
allowing them to.
Yeah. It's not funny, but for real, like, listen to what,
I'm not laughing, but no, I get it.
But that
you're
shit,
allowing them.
This shit sound crazy to say out loud, like, that's really what the fuck you doing.
Yeah.
You allowing somebody.
Because nobody wants to hear the real.
Right.
The real is, and I even had to accept that with myself, the real is you're allowing, ain't nobody doing shit that you are not allowing them to do. When somebody hurts your heart, that's a feeling. Mm-hmm. Feelings are temporary. And you're allowing them to continue to happen.
Yeah.
So if you don't want this motherfucker to do these things to you anymore, or this individual ain't gonna be all harsh and call him a motherfucker.
You goddamn motherfucker.
But if you don't want this individual to do these things to you anymore, then don't let him.
Right. Simple.
It's simple, but it takes steps.
Oh, for sure. But that knowing,
yeah.
And that believing. That shit is that simple. If you really want something and you say that shit, that's what manifestation is.
Yeah.
If you really want something and you believe that shit and you really know that you're going to make that shit happen, don't ask yourself, okay, what do I need to do it? Do you want to do it? Do you want to do it? Do you really want to do it? Stop asking yourself the questions, the steps that it needs to take, that one step and wanting to do it.
Mm-hmm.
That's it. That's all you got to do. Everything else will come afterwards. Mm-hmm.
The other part of it is allowing. That's why it's important that we have a spiritual foundation. Yeah, you know, and sure. Allowing spirit to guide us.
Yeah.
When we let, if our flesh is already emotionally distorted,
yeah, weak,
mentally and weak,
yeah,
why are we trying to let our flesh handle it?
Exactly.
And it can't. It's not in a place to handle it.
Right. Because a person who abusing you, they don't have that. They don't. That's something that they're not even thinking about.
Yeah. So it's important that we allow spirit,
right,
and ask God and truly trust in the higher source, higher power, Yahweh. You know. Whatever you refer to the higher power as, and allow them to guide us and ask to put it all in his hands, mm-hmm, and ask them to get us through it and move, you know, with purpose. And we don't need the sight. Let you
exactly.
be the sight.
Yeah.
Let you handle everything for me.
Right.
And when I got to that place, you know, things became better for me. Can you still experience things? Absolutely.
Hell yeah.
Absolutely, because the individual is going to be them.
Yeah, and you think that something be what you want? You think that should be what you want? Like, he'd be like, oh, I want this though. Do you need it?
Or you be thinking that's what you need.
Yeah, do you think that you really need that though? Like, do you think that would be the best?
But when you're in that emotional state, you can't tell me.
Nah,
you'd be like, I need. This is what I need. This is what I love. This is.
But when you frequencing higher than that, when you actually start to ask yourself these questions, that's when you know you becoming where you need. Mm-hmm. That's where you know that's what you need. You need to ask yourself questions, mm-hmm, because if you don't ask yourself these questions, of course you're gonna let any motherfucker can ask you. Mm-hmm. Questions. Like, it's no, you don't learn shit from that. Like, you learn nothing from a motherfucker asking you questions and you just answering. You got to ask yourself shit. Like, if you don't ask yourself these questions, is this something that I really need? Is this something that do I want this, or do I really need it? That's just right. Like when you go in a store, you ain't finna just buy everything that you see. Mm-hmm. Oh, because I want it. Oh, I should have this. This is something that I should have.
And even the individual who is the victim per se,
yeah,
we got to go down to their childhood traumas,
yeah,
and what they've experienced. You know,
they might turn into the abuser in a minute. Or yeah. they might have.
Hey, it's couples that be abusing each other.
Yeah, I was in a relationship where mentally abusive relationship back and forth.
Yeah,
back and
absolutely.
Forth. And it was, and that's the crazy thing, because that was the relationship that I felt like I was the happiest in, because it was comfortability. I was comfortable with a person doing the same shit that I do to people. That's it. That's mentally abusive. Like that. Mm-hmm. I know that I could possibly be mentally abusive, but it turned it into a game. Mm-hmm. Like, who gonna outdo? But we can be cool.
But
we
it's
can be
draining.
Draining as fuck. But you don't get drained until you start to ask yourself those questions, because you don't realize it. You don't realize what's going
on. Once you get in that state of like, this shit ain't even okay. What the fuck is we doing?
Right, exactly. And somebody got to get to that state.
And the other individual not going to like
it. It's like drugs. Mm-hmm. That shit like drugs. One motherfucker, y'all doing dope together. One motherfucker try to get clean.
Crack. Is it crack?
Crack cocaine.
Is it crack?
Y'all doing crack cocaine together. Motherfucker, one motherfucker going to try to get clean. Y'all been tied to each other with this shit for so long. Man, for real though, because it's like this shit ain't good for me. This shit ain't good for me. One of us gotta climb up out of this shit.
Mm-hmm. And the other individual that's still in that state, they're gonna be looking at you or be upset with you because you no longer want to experience what you're experiencing, and it's not fair.
But we was in this together. Why the fuck do you want
to? We supposed to make this work,
right? No, baby,
I need you like you need me.
I'm elevated.
Those are all tactics of the abuse, you know. So it's important that. It's important that people know and understand that when it comes down to being these type of relationships or experiences, that go within.
Yeah,
go within and don't try to change this motherfucker. Don't try to get them to a place where you feel like they can be better. Work on you and pray for you and heal you. Because then that's going to be your answer in the end. Mm-hmm. And you're going to get up out of that because you're going to realize this is not what the fuck I'm supposed to be experiencing. This is not what the fuck I'm supposed to. Yeah. This is not what I'm worth.
Right. Stop asking. Stop trying to wait until a motherfucker do good if they've been doing shitty by you this entire time. If you telling yourself, like, I'm tired of this shit, but a motherfucker do something the next day. At this point, you waiting for a motherfucker to do some bad shit to you. Cause you already at that point where you like, I'm tired of this shit. I just need a new motherfucker. I need a new man. I need a new woman at this point. But it's like, but then if they don't do nothing to upset you, then you comfortable again.
You're comfortable again. You're like, oh, she's been doing good.
Said that you was tired. Are you tired or do you want to continue to race? Mm-hmm. Which one? Because once you get to the end of what are you racing for? What are you racing for?
And then if you're tired, are you really tired and then going to be with self after
you gonna be
to
tired
heal
then.
From all of the experience that you've been going through in this journey? Are you just going to hop into
some other shit?
And then that even go down to the people that be like, I don't know, I just have this type and I'm always attracting this type and I'm always you're attracting this type.
Yeah.
So let's go within. And work on self and work on your emotions and your mental so that your vibrations of your thoughts and your frequencies can stop attracting these type of individuals to you.
Right.
And that's the most important thing. Yeah, right. And it's like, but even then, with the dark experiences, you still got to appreciate them. Because if you didn't experience them, like, you don't know what love is until you experience hate.
Yeah.
You don't know what hate is until you experience love.
Mm-hmm.
It's duality in dark and light and all the experiences. When you down, the only way is up.
Right.
So then when you're down, you have to learn to get up and find that light. But then once you get in that light and be in that purposeful auric field, whatever you want to call it, be like, damn, I'm grateful for that.
Yeah,
I'm grateful for that dark moment.
You gotta be.
You know what I mean? And we got to forgive. Yeah. We got to forgive yourself. That's the most important thing before you forgive anybody else. You got to forgive yourself for going through the experience, for allowing things to happen. And then that's going to help you to project and forgive others. So it's important that you do that for yourself. Yeah. So when people be walking around all angry and just sick towards other people, that's an internal struggle, my nigga. That's internal, but their main argument is what people did to them.
Yeah.
It's done though.
Fuck them.
But not even that. It's done.
Yeah.
Okay, they did this to you. Now what?
Yeah.
Now what? But when you say it to people like that, they think you being insensitive or rude or careless when you say now what? Because all we can do is live in the now in the moment.
What's next? We can't
take away the past
right.
and we can't predict the future.
Exactly.
We can put out our vision and expectations for the future, but we still don't know what's going to happen.
Exactly.
And unless you fully put that intent into it and expect it to happen.
Right.
Now at that point, you're using your manifestation gifts and creational gifts.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, that still ain't now.
Yeah.
Now is
right.
The shit has happened. Mm-hmm. Now what?
You tired. You gonna be tired tomorrow too. What you gonna do today? If you're tired, you gonna get up and get some energy or what? Are you still gonna be tired? You just tired. And now tomorrow you're gonna be tired too. Because what the fuck you do to shake yourself up? You ain't did shit. You ain't did shit. You still laying there. Mm-hmm. You tired though. If you tired, then go to sleep. Think about it and then wake up feeling better the next day. And it's not that easy though. It's not that easy.
That thought of you
being tired and you knowing that you don't want to continue to be tired. That's the step that you need to be trying to figure out. Like, and why are you tired? Are you tired because you just did some shit that you know that's going to be beneficial to you down the road? Like, oh, fuck, I just worked this long ass shift. I'm tired. Or are you tired of what somebody else is doing to you? What? Like, you can't be, you choosing this. I choose to go to work this long ass shift. I choose to let a motherfucker make me feel tired if I'm tired.
But that's the worry and the fear. The worry exactly. And the fear is, okay, in this moment, I fucking hate or I'm tired of this job making me work 12-hour shifts, but you're still getting up to go do it. So are you going to worry about, right. And the thing is, people worry because they're like, well, if I quit, yeah. If I look at it like this, this is my personal thought on it. When a person doesn't want to leave a job that they hate, when a person don't want to leave a job that they fucking hate and miserable about and tired of and be stressed and emotionally all distraught about, to me, you have a broken mindset and an unworthiness mindset because you don't feel like you're worthy enough of receiving a better job or shit, starting your own business.
You don't believe in yourself.
You don't believe in yourself to stop doing something that you do not like and that is depleting you mentally and emotionally and even physically because you don't feel like you worthy enough of receiving a better job. I've never been like that. I'll quit the job some motherfucking fast if I'm not happy. I'm not happy. I'm worthy of getting another good ass job.
The thing is, I go into shit. If I'm not, I have to be happy in my job or I'm not working.
I'm not going
to
do that shit.
I'm not working it. I create my own happiness. Mm-hmm. You create your own happiness. If you go into a fucking job and you just don't want to go there, you already out gate. You don't want.
But what's irritating is the people who complain about it all the fucking time. And it's like, okay, I'm the other individual and I got to hear you complain about this shit all the time. All the time. And then you ain't leaving. Like, you get what I'm saying? Like, I know people that be complaining about their job, been complaining about that motherfucker for 2 years. And I'll be like, this shit is annoying because either you shut the fuck up because you're still fucking there.
Yeah, you change it.
Or change it. Change your reality. Mm-hmm. And know your worth and trust in God. And know God gonna bless me with another job. Because
mm-hmm. It's your reality.
Because it's your reality. Attract it. Yeah. Attract the same job. Yeah. Attract even better. Yeah. You never know. Sometimes when you make that step out on faith, because all faith is the
belief, yeah,
the
belief.
Substance of all things hoped for. Exactly. So when you step out on faith, that substance will create and you may get a better job than you had within last 10 years at this job because you finally let the fuck go. Mm-hmm. Letting go can be so healthy in so many areas in your life, not just with jobs. Mm-hmm. You can let go and then experience I know people that let go of abusive ass relationships mm-hmm. year later with the love of their life. Mm-hmm. Beautiful relationships. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So it's like that letting go part, right. But that letting go is the trust.
Yeah.
And that trust is within you. And exactly. The part that's within you is the divine, the right. Divinity.
Right.
You know, so it's important that we do that for ourselves. And, you know, even talking about it can be easier said than done. Mm-hmm. But if you work on it mm-hmm. and transform yourself and continue to activate that within you, you can get to that place mm-hmm. of being like, oh, fuck that.
Yeah.
I don't deserve that.
Yeah.
Oh, my worth is more than that.
Yeah.
And then even if you get in a situation where you experience something again, because we can all still experience situations for sure. That are unhealthy or not the best, all you got to do is remember mm-hmm. and get back to that state of saying, nah, fuck that. Mm-hmm. Sharia gave us some hearts. Hey, friend.
Hey, sexy.
Gang, gang. Gang, gang. My tourist loves. Yeah, we out here. Tourist loves.
Big trip.
Big trip over here. So how y'all feel about abuse? Let's take some.
Taking some callers.
Yeah, you listening to Ice Storm. How do you feel about abuse? Yes, Kim. Our listeners on the podcast going to be like, what were they doing? We're on social media asking for questions from individuals. So Kim is my instructor for Yoni Steeman. She has an entire school, Black Girl Magic. She's so educated, so knowledgeable in the subject and the practice, and it's so beautiful. And I love it. And she's really big on the healing of the divine woman, the divine feminine, and our energy, but also acknowledging the divine masculine and the importance of their healing as well, because they are a part of us. We are reflections of one another. Hey, Jackie. So I don't think nobody has any questions. So we might have to wrap this up.
All right. I'm hungry, man.
Me too. Thank y'all for tuning in to Rules to Them Crowns podcast. Make sure you follow us on Facebook at Rules to Them Crowns podcast. Also, you can email us at Rules to Them Crowns podcast at gmail.com if you have any subjects, if you would like to be a guest on the show, or if you just got some good ass feedback for us or corrective criticism for us as well. We are very, very open to it. Oh, we do have a question. Okay, let me go back. Yes, that is absolutely true, Kim. She said, as far as abuse goes, we tend to abuse ourselves. And that's absolutely true. At the beginning of the episode, we did talk about a form of abuse, which is self-sabotaging. And that is something that we could definitely do to ourselves. And we can just beat ourselves up. And ways of putting ourselves down is abuse, you know, making us not feel like we're worthy enough for certain things or for greater is definitely a form of abuse. So we have to be mindful of the things that we think when it comes to just ourselves, which could then project onto another individual and cause them to abuse us, which a lot of people will not take accountability in that. Yeah. How you view yourself, just as like, you know, the little saying, a nigga gonna do what you allow. So it's like, if you doing certain things or you're carrying yourself a certain, am I making an excuse for the abusive behavior? Absolutely. No, disclaimer, because motherfuckers will try to, you know, transform your words, but they will see that within you and see that you don't have worth. You know, I've dated men that have been like, you made me be a better man to you than I was to them, because they didn't make me be a better man to them. So I treated them the way that I wanted to fucking treat them. Mm-hmm. And it's like, you know, that shit is real. Mm-hmm. And that's because of the abuse that we're doing to ourselves. We're not showing our worth. We're not appreciating ourselves. We're not showing the love, self-love. Mm-hmm. And then that is objective. You know, it's seen. Mm-hmm. And then motherfuckers' energy play off of that. And then that's when it becomes a reflection. Ever heard of your upper limit? No, I don't know what that is. What is that?
But you willing to tolerate
upper limit? Wait. Maybe I understand it, but never heard of that particular way of explaining it. Elaborate, Kim, before we get off of here. It means you only allow yourself, hold on, let me put this over here. It means you only allow yourself the level of happy that you're used to. And once you reach that threshold, you self-sabotage. Mm. Mm. So what, it's like what an individual feel like they only worthy of. Oh, I ain't worthy of a rich man. Some people think like that. And then the self-sabotage is, if they get it, they don't even know how to accept it or handle it, because they never thought that they were worthy of it. Yeah. That was something that I had to learn as well when it came to my manifestations. You know, we pray for these things to God. You get people, oh, God, just get me out of this. And, oh, God, bring this to me. Or, oh, God, can I have this? And then it come and you like, this ain't fucking real. Or see, you don't know how to accept it.
My thing was, I expected. My best friend said that she thinks I'm entitled, because my mindset is like, most of the time, like, I knew I was gonna get that shit, or I knew it was gonna happen, so I don't ask. Like, if I'm not asking for it, then I'm not entitled. How am I entitled if I don't ask for it? You know what I'm saying? Like, she like, We do shit. For, like, everybody just do shit for you. Like, you just so entitled. And I'm like, I never ask anyone to do shit for me. So it's like, but I'm entitled.
But you could be unconsciously doing that, though.
But how?
The conscious part of you is not.
How? But exactly, though. But it's like,
it can be embedded.
Or could it be my belief system doesn't have to ask if I just know that I'm going
you
to
you deserve
get it.
Of it.
Yeah.
You deserving of
so
it.
So it's like, I'm not entitled.
That's the unconscious just, embedment that yeah. you feel like you deserve it.
Right. Yeah. That's so it's like, that's not entitlement.
But it's about when you receive it, how you act, how you receive it, how you project things to the individuals that are doing these things for you.
Interesting.
Yeah. And the way that you receive it can seem like you feel like you're entitled instead of saying, this is what I'm worthy of and right. explaining it. It's about our behavior.
But who am I telling this is who I'm worthy of if I feel like this is what I'm worthy of? I ain't telling nobody that shit. I'm worthy of it. That's it. Like, what should my response be to something that I feel like once you get something, you get it and you like, I knew I was going to get that shit. That shit, I knew it. Like, I knew it for the simple fact that that's what I wanted and I believed in it. And it's like you said, you could get anything that you want.
Mm-hmm.
Anything that you want. That's how I feel the same. I feel the same way. And you putting those steps forward to even those beliefs that you even got in your head to be like, I'm going to get that shit like. Like, it's nothing that it don't even take effort for me to get something that I really want. Like, sometimes it don't take me having to pray on it or me having to continue to talk mm-hmm. about it. I could just think something
yeah,
and be
because
like,
of the frequency that you're in, yeah, the vibration.
Because
that's
something that you already got. Mm-hmm. That's something that you already
because you're already expecting it.
Yeah, or not even expecting it. It's just something that that's what you putting it out. So that's what you're going to get back. You know what I'm saying?
Right. That's the same people are not aware of their upper limit, but your subconscious is well aware and will manifest a situation that will ruin what you have achieved.
Yeah.
You already expected it, but subconsciously, this is already embedded within you.
But then again, it's like, I don't have expectations. I only have expectations to what I set and for myself.
Your conscious may not have an expectation, but your unconscious could have these things embedded in it already. A lot of times we can have that.
But you also, if what's the difference between you manifesting something and you expecting something is going to happen for you?
The transforming of how you think.
What? So is there a negative transforming of it, or what's the divide?
So it's more of like making sure you're releasing it if it's embedded already. Like if you feel like you don't do that, but then things keep happening that way. And then you see how people are reacting to you of how you react when you receive certain things. Like you said, your best friend said you feel like you're entitled.
No, and that said that I'm entitled. She's like, you just get everything. You spoil. But I'm like, what am I doing to make people do that? I ain't did shit. I ain't asking for shit. I'm not expecting you to do shit for me at the same time either. I'm not that type of person that I just already expect for people to do things for me. It just be happening like that sometimes, but I don't expect things to just happen. Exactly. It's something that I believe that maybe I just deserve it and I'm just getting it. Like, that's just what I feel like I deserve it. So it's nothing that
there's nothing wrong with feeling like you deserve something.
Or not even feeling like I deserve it, just feeling
or
like
knowing that you deserve something.
Yeah, or not even knowing that I deserve it, just feeling like this is the course
tap
of
me
my
in, coach. Tap me in. Just come on, Kim. Oh, we need to get you on here. You all the way out of town.
Like, knowing that this is how things happen in my life, and this is how things have happened in my life. Like, as starting from a
so when
kid.
You receive these things that your best friend feel like you're entitled
it'd be crazy shit too. It'd be like, dude, how is that entitlement?
Do you show to the universe, to the higher power, whatever, to you, to yourself, that you're appreciative of it? Not just like, you know, some people that the energy or their mindset of entitlement will be like, well, yeah, when I'm not going to show how grateful I am for
no,
it.
Like, that's not even the type of person that I am. Like, I'm not the, because why could, if you know that, you think that that's how I am?
I don't know. I'm just listening. I'm listening.
That's ungrateful. Am I ungrateful? I don't think that I'm ungrateful at all. Because if I feel like, if I was ungrateful, most of the shit wouldn't happen for me the way it happened for me. not walking in how I walk. You know what I'm saying? That would be a low vibration for me. And I will also, everything that come after you being ungrateful, I will be hit with that. And I don't be hit with that for the simple fact that I feel like I'm walking where I need to be walking. And that's why I receive the things that I receive. The people that are I don't get any bad, like, I don't get any negative flack from a motherfucker thinking that I think it's just her just want to say shit. Like, at this point, I think thinking that she just be trying to say shit because she's like, okay, no, you're not entitled. Like, what the fuck?
What they said.
She said that same knowing what you want and attracting it will continue to flow, allowing the things that you are saying you didn't ask for to come. It's all aligned.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I feel like it's something that it's my life path. So this is I'm on my life path now. So everything
purposeful.
Everything is divine order. Absolutely. Everything is divine order.
And that's why. If we go back to what I said, nothing just happens.
Yeah,
it doesn't just happen.
Yeah,
you know, it all starts with energetic thought and creation.
So it's like, am I entitled? Because maybe you are a person who. You
doesn't have that worth, right? Or may not have the mentality of expecting the thing that you are worthy of,
or if you just seem like it's too easy for me. It's too easy.
Isn't that the worth? If you feel like, oh, that's just too easy for you,
like I don't go through shit, like I still go through.
But
shit.
It's not that it's too easy for this other individual. It's because they are manifesting it and they're creating it in their mind. Right. So, but again, it's also about how. Peace and love, queen. Peace and love. Mm-hmm. It's also about how you know, the actions behind receiving the blessing. So, I don't know. I can't speak
she
for...
She be lying. She be just joking and shit.
Yeah, I think she could be. And it's just to have open discussion and conversation. So
I think she just be going to see how I'm going to react to it. Because I'm like, what? No. Because I ain't.
Because it ain't that.
It definitely ain't that.
Okay, we got to wrap it up, y'all. I enjoyed y'all. Love, blessings. And sadate.
Sadate, my baby.